Hi, I'm Pat Sloan. I'm here for Leisure Arts to tell you about sewing machines. Do you have one? Do you need one? How would you go about finding one? Let me give you some tips. It turns out that you probably know somebody that has a sewing machine. All you have to do is sort of ask your friends, your coworkers, if they have a machine that you could borrow so that you could try it out and see what it's like. Let's say you actually want to buy a machine. Well, first of all, you might buy a used one. The best way to do that is to put out some ads. Put one ad up in your church bulletin board, your grocery store bulletin board. Say you're looking for a sewing machine. You might go to a used machine store. They actually have those. They're often called Sew and Vax, or you might go to a big fabric store that also sells sewing machines and see what kind of machines are there that you could look at as a used machine. So once you acquire a machine somehow, there's a few things you need to know about it. They're all different. There's all different brands. They all have the same basic features, but they might be in different places. So I'm going to give you a little look here at two machines and talk you through where their differences are, and then you'll know what to look for. So this machine here is a New Home, and this is a Bernina. Every machine is going to need thread. You use thread on the top and you use thread in the bobbin. Up on the top, this machine has the thread in the well. And over here, the thread is on a cone here, or it could be on a cone out here. This is really typical. Most of the time, your thread on the top will be up at the top of the machine. You also have the bobbin thread, and that's down in a front loading, or a top loading rather, machine here. And in a front loading, it'll be down here. You actually might have some that go in the end. So you want to find that like this. And here is what the bobbin looks like. And that's full of thread because in order to sew, your stitches have to have thread on the top and the bottom, which make that link. Now there's some other parts, like where do you wind the thread? Here's the bobbin winder here. And on this machine, it's up here. You might actually find them down on the lower part on some machines. Every machine will have a foot, a basic sewing foot like this. They'll also have a turn wheel, which turns the needle. This one has one over here. You might have a garage so you can house all your goodies, or you might not. This machine doesn't have a garage. It came with a box of goodies and you keep it in another box. Now, another part to the machine is the foot pedal. Just like your car, you have to run the machine. This is the foot pedal for this machine, and here is another style foot pedal, and those will be plugged in to the side of the machine. In addition to plugging in, you have the electric. These are tabletop models. You might actually find a model that sits in the table flush, and that's another option. So here's a little peek at what the machines look like so that when you start talking about finding a machine and talking to your friends, family, whatever, you know what's gonna happen when one shows up. Next thing I'm gonna do is tell you about threading, tell you how to check that the machine sounds okay, needles. So we'll do that in a second. Check out my online classes at ICan'tBelieveI'm.com or look for my books, I Can't Believe I'm Quilting and I Can't Believe I'm Sewing at LeisureArts.com. You can also come visit me, Pat Sloan, at my website, QuiltersHome.com.